Joe, he made a whole lot of money. Yeah, he bought himself another man's wife. Oh, he's so suave and debonair, he can lead any man's life. Now, I don't begrudge a man of money he's made, but money alone doesn't hurt good Grady's. But it's all fair and square that Joe is quid pro quo. Oh, his kids come around every other weekend, and you know he's father of the year. He buys them both some manly things to make sure they don't turn queer. Oh, he tells them boys that their mother's a cow, and they have two of everything now, and it's all fair and square that Joe is quid pro quo. Oh, and Beth decided after 15 years that her man didn't make the grade. So she ditched him and married Joe, and now she's got him made. She took one look at his February tan, and she adjusted those curves, and she made a plan. And it's all fair and square that Joe is quid pro quo. Oh, and we all know that Joe, he's a wealthy man. He demonstrates it every way he can. The one thing he doesn't show is humility, and no, and his quid pro quo, in case you did not know. Now Joe, he smokes his Cuban cigars, trophy wife is his greatest prize. He's gonna build a wing on his great big house, he's compensating for his size. And together they go to every Broadway show, they do not like him, but they still go, and it's all fair and square to Joe. Now Joey, no, how's that go? Now Joe made a fortune speculating that someone else would fail. And just when the stock hit the tipping point, he put it all up for sale. And he bested it all in a Ponzi scheme, and best she left when he ran out of steam, and everything's got is gone and up for sale. And it's all fair square to Joe is quit. It's all fair square to Joe is quid pro quo.